perfume is one of the greatest things in my world. It's just so selflessly revealing. I feel like the sense of being is decoded in its complex trail of unity. When you achieve equilibrium in a composition and you arrange a combination of oils to complement each other's vital force, you end up with a symphony of difference, and it moves like an ocean of contrasting voices swaying gracefully together in the mouth of the universe. You receive the information through smell, and the perfume communicates a hidden part of who you are. Perfume can tell you who you love. It can tell you why you love them. It can reveal your sexuality. It can even tell you what you are afraid of. Perfumes are powerful. They are emotional creatures. They live, they breathe. They are moments of silence concentrated in a bottle, and they force you to listen. I made a perfume recently, which is characteristically me. It has a fine balance of masculinity and femininity and smells like both confidence and vulnerability, and I connect to it emotionally because essentially the perfume is mirroring who I am. It's fantastic, and this is why I love perfumery and alchemy in general, because it's all about discovery, and discovery enlightens your soul. It enriches who you are, and I have nothing but respect for the experience and the interaction, because when I make perfume, I learn about myself, and when I learn about myself, I develop and change. I am the unfinished perfume, and my composition ends when I die. I can't describe the satisfaction I get from my sense of smell. Take the aromatics of curry, for example. Specifically this pork vindaloo, there's sweet cinnamon, there's clove, garlic, vinegar, coriander, turmeric, ginger, black peppercorns, cumin, cardamom, bay leaf, and it's just this intense experience. It's soothing, it's stimulating, it's warm and invigorating. It just slaps you in the face and wakes you up, and that's what I love about a perfume. Even if a perfume is subtle in its nature, they all inspire something from you. They all reveal just a little bit of who you are. They all tell you something about yourself. These are some of my favorite notes in perfumery. Maybe not the garlic, but you get what I'm trying to say. When you put things together, they become so much more than what they are on their own. And that's alchemy. Alchemy is everything. Everything is alchemy. Alchemy is what it's all about. I'm in the garden at the moment, preparing vegetable beds and herb beds, and looking forward to tincturing some of the things that I grow later in the year. I'm planting some clary sage, some borage, which is good for the soil, but I believe it has an interesting smell. I'm planting some marigolds, some cinnamon basil, English spearmint, chervil. There are just so many things you can grow and extract scent from. The garden is an amazing place to be for me. It's one thing to buy materials, but it's another thing entirely to grow the materials yourself and capture their scent in a bottle. That's what connects you to the central theme of perfumery, which is the bit before the blending, which is the extraction of the essential oils, which is the life force or the blood of the living thing, the plant, the tree, the flower, etc. It's like eating meat and killing the animal with your own two hands. It's the whole experience. I'm working on a couple of feminine perfumes at the moment, and I'll be sharing the formulas shortly. In the meantime, if you're interested in perfumery, as always, check out my website, www.sensuality.de, and you can find all of the basic information there.